I'll be going over the basics of how to load visuals inside of Resolume. And since the interface is the same between Avenue and Arena, this should apply to both. So first thing you'll want to do is go into Composition and change your settings. You'll want to make the size of the composition the same as your video clips. So I'll be running 1080p today. And you can go ahead and make your custom name for the composition. Alright, I'll hit apply, and you might have to adjust the windows a little bit to accommodate for the new composition settings. So there's two ways to load videos inside of Resolume. The first is by using the Finder if you're on a Mac, or Windows Explorer if you're on a PC. And it's pretty simple, you just click and drag your files directly into the empty slots on the Resolume interface. Just like this. You can also select multiple clips, and when you drag those into the empty slots, what it'll do is line those up sequentially in a row. Okay, let me clear the deck here. The second way to load visuals inside of Resolume is to use the built-in file browser, and it has a few advantages. The first being this AB tab here. What this does is lets you set up two different locations to pull visuals from. To the right of the AB tab is this preview button, and what this does is give you a rendered thumbnail of each of the visuals listed inside of your browser currently. And this is great because rather than rely on just file names, you can actually see what each file has. And by double clicking, you can load it up right here in the preview monitor for real-time previews. So I'll go ahead and load up the composition with some clips. Let's go with these three right here. On the top layer, the next three in the middle layer, and the final four on the bottom layer. So Resolume uses a layers workflow. Similar to Photoshop or After Effects, the topmost layer affects the layers beneath it. So depending on the blending mode, transition, or effects, the bottom two layers will always be affected by the top. And once you have your visuals loaded into the layers, you can just click and drag on its name and reposition it to whatever slot you choose. And by dragging a clip over another, it just swaps places rather than replace it. So to trigger a clip, you just click on its thumbnail, and it shows up in the output monitor, which is what your audience would see. To control the opacity of each triggered visual, there's a slider here with a V on it. And that stands for video. So by sliding that up or down, you can fade it in and out depending on your needs. So to remove a clip, you would hit the X here on the far left of each layer. So if you notice, when I trigger these clips, they snap in really fast. Sometimes you want a smoother transition, and that's what this slider here is for. This is the transition slider. And by moving the transition slider up, you increase the duration of the transition. You also have the option of choosing what type of transition by clicking on this button here, which lets you choose a transition effect. So I'll choose a wipe there, a tile there, and let's try rotate here. So now when you trigger a clip, you'll notice that the transition changes depending on the transition effect you chose. So that's tile right there, and if I trigger this clip, it does that rotate effect. The transition effects also apply to both the triggering of a clip and the exit of a clip. So if you take a look here on the output monitor, when I close these layers, the transition effect is applied to the exiting layer. So the other way to transition between layers is to use this AB crossfader here. And what this does is, if you look on each layer, there's an AB switch. And you can designate the layer to be either A or B on the fader. I'll go ahead and trigger some visuals here. it's going to take a little bit for the transitions to load. Since I have each layer set to A or B on the fader now, when I drag to the A side, you'll notice that the B clip disappears and vice versa. If you click directly on the A or B button, you'll get a smooth transition between the two, so you don't have to actually drag it if you don't want to. Also, keep in mind that the transition effects don't apply to the AB crossfader. If you're new to Resolume, the interface might be a little daunting, so there's this help window down here, which can be activated by going into the View menu and Show Help. And this is really useful because if you hover above some of the interface elements, you'll notice that it gives you a description to help you become more familiar with the interface. So those are the basics of loading visuals in Resolume. The visuals you've seen today are from a set called Strangescapes, available on our website. We also have some free content you can check out at docoptic.com. And thanks for watching.